Salve. Our perception of the world seems to be absolute for us, but we should remember that there was a time when the perception of the world was different. Today we are going to talk about the Romance of the Rose. Once again, in my previous video about the Romance of the Rose, I talked about the plot and the heroes of the romance. But today we are going to talk about the special things, the special and strange things that we can find in this kind of ouvrage littéraire. Let's look through several metaphors that I found for you in the Romance of the Rose. The first one is about the kiss.
Le baiser qu'il a de la proie, le mieux et le plus avenant, si a RS du remenant.
The idea of these words is that after a kiss, you should wait for something more. I think it's not so difficult to analyze this idea from the point of medieval thought. We can understand that the religious society prohibited to talk about a kiss in general, but here we talk about something more than a kiss. The second example.
Elle ressemblera des fées. Du grand tâteur que elle avoit, bien peut connoître qu'il avoit qu'elle n'a pas de religion.
Here we talk about the magic. So, what was the magic for medieval people? For those who wrote books for the whole country, it was unreal to write about magic without having then problems with the church. Because I think that writing about religion was the first and the only topic that we can find in the books of medieval age. But here we see some examples where the author talks about a woman who is so magical that she can be compared to a goddess, to a fairy, and she has nothing to do with religion, he says. So, what do you think? Is it legal? I gave you two examples of the text, and in general, if we talk about the idea of the garden, of the paradise that is described in this artwork, we can mention that in this garden people do whatever they want. So they make love, they kiss, and what do you think? Is it possible for a medieval age to have such an artwork talking about love, talking about making love, kissing, and talking about magic? I think this is the answer why the Romance of the Rose has become such a famous artwork. If you once read something except the Romance of the Rose, you can mention that there is no magic, there is no sexuality. So it's very interesting why this happened and why this artwork wasn't prohibited, wasn't banned by the medieval society.
See you soon and bye.